Hello, this is DrSayus, and today I'm going to talk about 10 must-watch animes on Netflix. Now, there's a few that I mentioned in my past videos, such as Castlevania. That's definitely one worth watching. The reason I'm not talking about it is because I already talked about it in my last video. I'm going to get the obvious ones out of the way first. First off, One Punch Man. One Punch Man got a lot of hype at its launch. I watched it and it does live up to it quite well. It's based on the strongest hero. He defeats everyone with one punch. He's depressed because he defeats everyone too quickly. He's protecting the city from monsters. He finds out there's a hero organization, so then he joins that. He tries to work his way up being a hero. He meets a protege, Cyborg, who he accompanies on his journey. You'd think it'd be really boring because he's so strong, what's the point? But a lot of comedy in Japan, the rest of us, like, we don't understand it. Like, that bit when they're like, all the Japanese people go, let's do this, that's supposed to be funny, but like the rest of the world's like, that's just weird. There's none of that in One Punch Man. It's the comedy, it's like it's tailored towards the West, and it is one of the best animes I've seen. It's too bad there's not many episodes for it, but that's a topic for another day. I don't really need to say too much about One Punch Man. If you haven't seen it, give it a go. Another big one is Attack on Titan. This is my favorite one on Netflix. It's about these kids. Their home gets destroyed by Titans, and the main character sees his mom get eaten by one. Titans are big giant monsters who only care about eating humans, so he wants revenge. So then they get moved to a different fortress. The world's just made up of like these fortresses to protect from the Titans from the outside world. Him and his friends join the training camp. They meet new friends. Once he graduates from that, they join like a team of people who go outside the walls to fight the Titans and get resources and things. What I like about Attack on Titan is it's very black. A lot of animes are like, oh, the hero always saves the day. Most modern animes are like, nobody dies, or like rarely anybody dies. Everybody dies in Attack on Titan. it's ridiculous, but I like it. I like the realism. There's also like other realistic things, like there's no fat people. Nothing against fat people, but I like that realism, because yeah, food is of a scarcity. There wouldn't be any fat people, you know, it's just the way it is. I think there is a fat guy later on, but like he's rich, so yeah, definitely worth watching. If you don't like seeing people die, it's probably not for you, to be honest. But for me, I can't get enough of that shit. Next, I'm going to say two. I'm going to put two in the one slot because they're pretty much the same series. Fullmetal Alchemist and Fullmetal Alchemist Brotherhood. Fullmetal Alchemist doesn't really follow the manga. They kind of tell their own story, but they tell it quite well. And then Brotherhood follows the manga. If you have the time, I would watch both of them. Watch Fullmetal Alchemist first, then Brotherhood. If you don't, just watch Brotherhood. Pretty much it's about these kids. Mom dies. I think she was sick or something. They learn about alchemy and try to bring her back to life, but it ends up backfiring. One of them loses his arm and leg, and the other one like loses his whole body, and the other brother transfers his body into like a suit of armor. So then they have to find out how to get their bodies back. So then they end up like leaving their hometown, trying to become alchemists. They meet like some really dangerous people who they have to end up fighting against. I like Attack on Titan. People do die, not quite as much, but I like that sort of blackness. So if you're into that, give that a go. Next is one I discovered a few months ago. It's called Black Lagoon. A Japanese businessman, he leads a very boring life, and he's pretty much like kicked around by his boss. I could relate to him a wee bit because past jobs, like I've been used and abused. He was abducted by pirates. Since then he decides to leave his old life and join them. Life is a lot more exciting, but also a lot more dangerous. He does all the business stuff for them. He has like a lot of chemistry with the girl who's a bit of a psychopath. There's like a girl who likes to shoot people. There's like a guy who looks like The Rock. He's like a black guy. He's pretty badass as well. He's the calm, cool, collected type, but he's also pretty formidable in a fight. After that, Death Note. Death Note's a big one. All these animes, they're all in Japan, and most of them are Japanese students. Anyway, he finds a notebook on the floor with the power to kill anyone. I think he starts off by like killing a bully, and then he like kills like all these like murders he hears on the news. Any sort of criminals, like rapists, murderers, real psychopaths. He's also like a genius, so he's able to like use his brain to figure out how to do it without getting caught. But then another genius from the government that catches on to him. He tricks him in trying to uncover his identity. So it's interesting, like the battle of the minds back and forth. The character he's fighting against is called L. L kind of knows who he is, but he doesn't really have the proof. So he's trying to like get the proof against him and stuff. So it's really good, the back and forth between the two. But it's funny because the main character, Light, a bit ironic the name, he's really good looking, he has a really high IQ. His career is pretty much set, like his dad works in the police force, and whenever he graduates he wants to work in the police force. Like, you'd think a guy like that, his life's set up for him, like he wouldn't risk his life. He's very self-righteous, so he's like, he wants to get rid of all the evil in the world. He ends up getting a bit twisted in the end. But it is really good. And I have to mention this, the first opening's really good of the anime, but then the second opening, they completely botched it. I don't know. It's like this sort of heavy metal, sort of, like screaming into the microphone. I don't understand why they did that, but a minor nitpick. It's still really good, worth watching. Another one, I googled best animes, and somebody put this as their favorite anime. It's called Steins Gate. It's about this sort of mad scientist, of course, in Tokyo, and he's a university student. Him and his friends end up inventing this sort of microwave phone. I think they put like a banana in the microwave or something, and they send like a text message to somebody, and it sends the text message in the past, and this ends up changing the present. He ends up like doing it for his friends. Like, I think one of them wanted to be a girl or something, so he ends up doing that. Eat more vegetables and you'll get a girl, things like that. Like, it's interesting like how the world changes, and it doesn't quite work out the way he would want it to, and then he has to find a way to change it back. But there's problems with that, the whole issue of time travel. There's no fight scenes or anything in it like that, but it's entertaining. I like the character. He's a bit like myself, only I'm not quite as crazy as that. And you also find out when he's changing the past, you find out about other characters in the show, and they're not who you think they are. One of them ends up being like a killer or something. Just watch it, it's really good. After this we have Code Geass. My cousin Michael, who plays Apex, recommended this one to me. If you like Gundam, you'll love Code Geass. Of course, it's a teen in Tokyo, yeah, whenever, gets a Sharingan from Naruto, so he's pretty much Sasuke and he can make people do whatever he wants. There's a limit to it though, you can only use it on each person once. Of course, he has a very high IQ and he's able to like get his way out of basically any situation. He ends up leading the Japanese rebellion against Britannia, because Britannia is like, they're like an English colony who have overtaken Japan, and Japan, there's like a small group of terrorists who want to get their country back. He becomes the leader of them and he helps fight. His dad is like the leader of Britannia, so it's really good. He has like a double life, like one life he's a student and he has to trick everybody into thinking he's like not doing anything suspicious, and then the other side of him's like the leader of this terrorist organization. After this, my brother introduced me to this one. It's called Erased. Pretty much it's this guy, he's a bit of a loser, he kind of lives with his mom, he works at a pizza place, he's like sick of life, he doesn't socialize with anybody. He comes back home and his mom's murdered, and he's framed for the murder. When he gets caught by the police, he like screams in a panic and he suddenly gets transported to the past. Then he finds out he can go into the past and he can change the future. It only sends him into the past when he's like a kid at school. And when he's at a kid in school, you find out about these girls who end up getting killed. He knows who the girls are because in the future they're in the newspaper. So he tries to stop these things from happening, like he follows them about, and in the process he's trying to find out like who killed his mother. Another one I liked is called Tokyo Ghoul. You guessed it, Tokyo teenager. He's like no confidence. If you watched my video where I talked smack about Neon Space Evangelion, it's the same sort of guy. He's not quite as bad as that guy, but he's still bad. Like, I don't like the main character in this. Goes on a date with this girl and he wakes up as a vampire. It ends up like he only drink blood for sustenance. Of course he gets panicky about that. He ends up working in a coffee shop with vampires, and they show him the ropes of how to live like a peaceful life as a vampire. But then of course outside the coffee shop you have like all these vampires who are like merciless killers, so then he has to fight against them. Hello guys, hope you're having a fantastic day. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a like and to subscribe for more videos. Bye.